So I wasn't sure if I should record this with the GoPro or with my phone. So I decided to go all out and just use the good camera. But why not? Today is a special day. Not only is it Christmas Eve, but it's also the day of my last chemotherapy. So I thought I'd do another cancer update video. Could possibly be the last one, hopefully. So we're on our way to Moorabbin Hospital and the cancer day unit there for my 12th and final chemotherapy treatment. Because it's our last, and because everyone at Moorabbin has been so nice to us, we've got a little gift for them as well. It's one of Mandy's artworks, resin artworks, depicting a cancer ribbon in purple, which is pancreatic cancer. I've just got it, and I don't know if you can see, that's what we're going to present to them. And there's a little message on the back from us. So that's what we'll be presenting to the nurses at the Moorabbin Cancer Day Unit today. Well done, Mandy. Nice bit of artwork there. Just give us that thumbs up again, I didn't quite catch it. Thank you. So what will happen today is what's been happening for the last 12 fortnights, 12 chemo sessions. We'll start off with some drugs to preempt the reaction that I get to the oxaliplatin, I think is how you say the drug that I get a reaction to. So there's a couple of what are they called?
Steroid
drugs that they give us. But we also call it sleepy juice because it puts me to sleep. But it does reduce a lot of the reaction that I get, where I get the pins and needles, the tingling in the mouth and the tongue, and it makes it hard to talk. But it does. But those preemptive drugs do make me rather sleepy. So I'm not sure whether I'll be able to talk to you on the way home, but we'll see how we go. And the final thing they do before we leave today is attach a bottle to me with the last drug, which actually takes 48 hours to go through. So that means tomorrow, Christmas Day, I'll be attached to a bottle. But that's what we've got to do. And then after that, hopefully that'll be the end of it. I'll have some more scans in February, on the 10th of Feb, just to make sure everything's all right. And hopefully that'll be it. Be back to work full time next year. So all going well, this should be the last cancer video, but we'll come back to you if I'm able to talk and I'm awake. I'll film a little bit on the way home. We'll probably film a little bit in the hospital today. And then we'll come back and see the bottle coming off for the last time. Anyway, good thing about being Christmas Eve is a lot of people have stopped work already, and there's not much traffic, so we're making good time. Anyway, see you soon. Even though it's summer, we've still got the temperature wars going on. It's early morning, so Mandy's got the heater on, 25 degrees on her side. For me, that's a bit warm. It's 18 degrees on my side. Mandy's even got her heated seat turned on. So yes, the temperature wars. How are you feeling, Mandy?
Fine.
A bit warmer now?
Yes.
Can we turn the heater down?
Yep.
Why not?
Because.
while I'm on the way home from my 12th and last chemotherapy treatment. It still knocks me around a bit. I feel really horrible and tired, and it's a little bit hard to talk. So we're just gonna go home, and I'll rest some more, and we'll get ready for Christmas tomorrow. I'll see you then. Cheers.
Cheers.
Well, it's the next day, Christmas Day. Merry Christmas, everyone. Because I had the chemotherapy yesterday, I've got a chemo bottle around my neck, which is attached in there. But because it's Christmas Day, we have a family tradition. It's the 10th year of our family tradition of taking a family photo in front of the tree before we open presents. But I want to make this a little bit discreet. So this is the last time I'll have this bottle. It'll come off tomorrow, because yesterday, or this session, is my last chemo session. So let's see if I can get this sorted. Get rid of that. Pass this down through there. Hide the tubes. And then I'll stick this so I can stick the bottle in my pocket so I can be Mr. Discreet. Alright, now we'll get on with our family photo of everyone. Just quickly, let's just show you a bit of the behind the scenes. So this is the good camera, the Lumix, that I'm going to use for video today. I do have an on-camera flash for the Lumix, but I just can't get it to work right. So I've got the old OMD Olympus up there with its built-in flash, and that'll take the family photo. Are we ready? Josh has finished dying. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Yep.
Yep.
Run with that?
All right.
Yep.
Yep.
Let's run with that.
So I've just finished Christmas lunch out at my sister's place out in the bush, out at Churchill in Gippsland. Had a nice Christmas lunch there, outdoors, under the patio. Just having a bit of a walk around there, the nice big backyard. Trying to make some room for pudding. So nice and quiet out here. Had a phone call from the hospital in the home nurse. Normally the day after chemotherapy, they'll come out to home and take my temperature and blood pressure and stuff like that. But we convinced them that being Christmas and that we wouldn't be home, that we'll just do that over the phone. So that was a quick phone call this morning just before we left home. Then tomorrow they will come out and disconnect the bottle. I've been able to keep things pretty discreet. I've got the connection there, the port, but the bottle's down in my pocket. So anyway, that's what we're doing on Christmas Day. So at my sister's today, tonight we'll just have a light dinner at my sister-in-law's. Alright, Christmas night at my sister-in-law's. Had another big feed for Christmas dinner. And I'll tell you what, I'm as full as a goog and a woog. I don't know if you've heard that saying before, but when I have a big feed, I'm as full as a goog and a woog. Got the Christmas hat from the Christmas cracker. I'll be heading home soon and sleep off all this food. Tomorrow, Boxing Day, will just be a quiet one. And we'll wait for the nurse to come out and see me and take off this chemotherapy bottle for the last time, and that will officially end my chemotherapy treatment. So looking forward to that. So it's now a couple of days after Christmas. Yesterday was Boxing Day, and I just took it really easy, just caught up on some sleep, because Christmas Day was really busy. I didn't get to have any nana naps or anything like that, because the day before that, Christmas Eve, when I had my chemotherapy, I end up sleeping a lot of the time there in the hospital, and then that throws out my sleep for that night and makes me tired the next day. But because it was Christmas Day, we didn't get much chance to rest. So yesterday, Boxing Day, I was just catching up on some sleep, watched a bit of the Boxing Day cricket, did a little bit of video editing. You might have seen the family Christmas morning photo video I put out. But yesterday was just mainly just catching up, taking it easy. But I did get the bottle taken out, the chemotherapy bottle that gets attached to the power port that I've got under the skin. The nurse came out to home, removed it for the last time. So all going well, that should be the end of chemotherapy for me. I will have another scan. I've got to check up with the oncologist on the 10th of Feb, and then there'll probably be scans either late Feb or early March, just to make sure that everything's okay and there's no sign of any growths anywhere else in the body. And then they'll decide whether that power port comes out. They said if we're optimistic, we'll take it out. If we're pessimistic, we'll leave it in. But I'm optimistic that we should be making a full recovery. But the last lot of scans didn't show any sign of any extra growth. So I'm feeling really lucky that we've been able to get through this. And 2020, back to normal. Back to a normal life. No hospitals, no chemotherapies, no all of that business. I will have regular checkups. It'll be every 3 months and then every 6 months. But apart from that, back to normal. Today, I've just been taking it easy again, watching a bit more of the cricket. A bit more video editing for the video that you're watching now. Had to chase up some missing online orders that didn't arrive in time for Christmas, but it was sitting at the post office all the time. They just didn't tell us, but I've gone down and got that. So Mandy will get a nice surprise when she gets home today, even though a Christmas present is going to be a bit late. But anyway, that's it. Unless there's some disaster or relapse or growth or something that they pick up, this will be my last cancer update video. Thank you again, everybody, for your support this year. I really, really appreciate it. And I'll see you in the next video. Cheers. Come on, Aussies.